Hola, my name is Jose Lopez.
And I'm Jessica Martinez, and estamos in Fisher Hall, room 226, and we are looking at René Magritte's The Lovers, an oil painting made in 1928.
So Jessica, what exactly are we looking at?
Well, Jose, it's a painting of a couple that is in a very intimate embrace while kissing, but as you can see, it's no ordinary kiss.
Ooh, kinky.
Anyway, their faces are covered with white veils. Tell me, Jose, what do you think Magritte's intentions were for doing this?
Well, it seems that Marguerite's purpose in this painting is to provoke us with mysterious and unsettling feelings.
I agree. I don't know about you, but the veils make it feel like they're hiding something very personal about each other, with the fear of it coming between them.
Yes, in a sense, I think that they're choosing to ignore their secret to protect their relationship.
But what they really don't know is that the secret is actually keeping them from fully knowing each other in every aspect. Another detail is that the woman seems to be of a different race.
That is very interesting. Now that you mention that, notice how the man is standing and how he just leans his head down to kiss the woman, while she has to tilt hers to kiss him.
You're right. If you ask me, it's a clear sign of his dominance over her. Marguerite seems to be incorporating so much into this simple painting. He is showing us the frustrated desire burning in the couple, but also the fact that they make no effort in removing the veil, as if they prefer to leave it and simply move on with what they're started. But he also shows us the way men view themselves over women.
You're right, Jessica. Men have always and will always be the dominant species. Just kidding. And the culture during that era is expressed very well in this painting.
So here we have a different piece of artwork by Robert Rauschenberg.
And it's called Erase de Kooning Drawing, done in 1953. So Jessica, when you first take a look at this piece, what is it that you see?
Well, Jose, I don't really know what to tell you. There's nothing there. I just see a dirty piece of paper.
Exactly. In Robert Rauschenberg, a retrospective, it says that there are traces of ink and a crayon on paper.
Are you kidding me? Do you really think this is art?
Yes, of course. It's eccentric, Jessica. The interesting thing about this work, unlike other pieces, is that it really challenges the question, what is art?
The most basic way to describe art is the way humans apply their creative skill and imagination to create a physical visual image.
But Rauschenberg doesn't seem to do that, does he? In a way, he's doing the opposite of that. The story behind this artwork is that Rauschenberg wanted to see if an artwork would still have the same value if it was completely erased. The task was a psychologically loaded deed of rendering another's artwork invisible.
So basically, he made art by physically destroying another artist's work.
Yes, he knew that the starting point for the project must be a drawing that was undeniably an artwork of significance. When he asked de Kooning, a superb artist of the time, if he could use one of his drawings, he agreed. Although he didn't really like what Rauschenberg was doing, he agreed to it because he respected the concept.
So are you trying to say that to de Kooning, the concept behind the work was actually more important than the work itself?
Yeah, I guess it sounds weird to put it like that. It's interesting to see how the notion of art has come to this, isn't it?
I know, the definition of art has progressed throughout the years, from skilled physical artworks to abstract concepts and ideas.
The San Francisco Museum of Modern Art shares with us that from 1951 to 1953, Robert Rauschenberg made a range of artworks that explored the limits and varied definition of art. These works recall and effectively extend the notion of artist as creator of ideas.
Rauschenberg literally erased the de Kooning's drawing. I mean, if I made a really good drawing and you erased it, my artwork would totally lose its value.
No, it wouldn't, because you're Jessica.
Yeah, that's right.
But in the case of Robert Rauschenberg, he only increased his value with the hard work that was put into it by de Kooning and erased by himself.
Well, Jose, it seems like we have run out of time.
Hasta luego.
Ciao.